pins and staples, real glue. There's some pins that got removed them. Just a one or two to keep everything in place. So I'm about to cut the doors now. I took a break, when I get something to eat, came back, it's night time. So this is it. These are the drawers. This is the top drawer here. This is the bottom drawer. I made sure that the rings fit before I go through any trouble prepping. So all I have to do is make the drawer faces for the project. I'm going to use this PVC. This is a old PVC door that I had just laying around. So I'm gonna cut this down to make the drawer faces. In the end, this is how it will look. As they all do, this is just a simple setup. Top drawer, bottom drawer, simple setup. Now all that's needed to be done is to be prepped and paint. So I got this paint today also. This is a gray automotive paint. A matte finish. Inside there will be a white paint. Here I'm installing these runners. I'm gonna start with the top one first. What I'm looking to do is achieve just over the drawer face of the runner. Hope y'all guys can see very clear what I'm doing. Just opening the bag of screws. I cut these pieces to give me the plate of the door. So this runner will just come. This runner will just come right above the drawer face here. When it's open, this piece will be above. So what you do is to release the outer part of the runner. Then you set it like. Then I set up my templates as such. Here's the templates. Just play ball in 16 from the front. Thank you. put in the bottom runners now. Same thing, release the outer part of the runner. That's the part that screws on to the drawer. This one is more measurement. I just place it right at the bottom. I'm going to put two screws in the bottom one because it's already resting on something, so it shouldn't fall to where it is. I just need these screws to stabilize it. So what I'm doing now is putting on the bottom part of the part that I took off earlier. This is the side B, part B. This is part B to the run. The first part you put on the side, the second part is thrown from the floor. So what I'm going to do here is just come to the bottom. Bring it flush to the front. This is the first drawer. It's going to be installed now. Let's put it into here like that. Into the other grooves like that. And voila. Smooth running. Going for the socket drawer now. What I do to make things easier to put on the drawer face, I used to drill a hole. Remember the part off of the door. I'm going to put this down, and this part will be the top. Seriously, the V-Zero type. And that's it, guys. So this is the top part of the vanity. This is to clear the piping. When the sink is installed, the pipe will come here into the back of the wall, and this will clear it. Then the bottom also has a recess in the back so that when the drain comes to this, when the downpipe comes to this part, it also clears there.
Just using some compressed air to clean out. Okay.
But that's it, guys.
As you can see, the cutout for the wall, waste. Then a deep drawer. Again, at the back, so the air can pass the waste. Smooth upgrading drawer runners. So that's it, folks. The tail on top,
yeah.
And a vessel sink.